ride the highway, ride the bus. Rocky. Walk my house, look like I'm in plus. Walk in the strip, she gon' make it bust.
In the kitchen real quick. All right, here's our kitchen where we make our full course meals. We got our waters right here ready for the tailgate today. Obviously a full functioning fridge. Don't ask about those. Dishwasher, sink, stove. We got the whole business.
Who's doing cooking?
Low key, it's like our Filipino guy, Gabe. He's low key like bomb ass cook. So is Rico. Shout out Rico. All right, we can go over here. There's a little laundry room. You got about 28 members, active members living inside this house. So it can get a little crowded, but like we make it work, you know, cute little laundry room. All right, let's go check out the breezeway. This is the breezeway connected to the house. This is kind of what we're doing, like our manufacturing carpentry work, like working on letters, dye tables, like shit like that. If you go over here, this is like another entryway. The way our house is designed, it's kind of like the front porch, back porch, rooms all right here, connected up, leading to our backyard. This is our backyard. Usually we have speakers set up, but again, it's tailgate day, so we need all the sound we can get right here. It's our lovely dye table, lovely windows right here. We like to play darts, dye, football, pretty much anything.
Who's the best at darts? You think you can handle it?
Probably Daniel or Jack. Okay. Jack's our vice president. You can meet him in a little
bit. Who's the best at ping
pong? Ping pong?
Cup pong.
Probably low key me. You. I'm kind of the goat. Okay. I don't think I've ever lost.
What's the record right now?
Cup pong?
Yeah.
Bro, like seven straight.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right,
let's go check out the actual fun. All right, over here is the back entryway. So the way we got our house set up, it's gonna be bathroom, two rooms. Over there, bathroom, two rooms, and it's the same thing going up. Same thing again, you know, bathroom, two rooms, since we got a whole 28 guys here in this house. And let me show you the party room. All right, this is the party room. This is where we do most of our functions. Tonight we got a Halloween party, so we're definitely gonna pop out for that. It's a costume theme. So, you know, we got our pledges, our active members working hard to decorate this place. It looks pretty nice right now, but it looks even better at night. So, I'll show you the bar. This is our bar area over here. You know, mixing up drinks for people, for guests, party guests, anything you want. You can come over here. Today we got bagels, mimosas, Bloody Marys, and a shit ton of tweed back there. Alright, Merce, let me introduce you to the president of Theta Chi, Mercer O'Connell.
How's it going, y'all? My name is Mercer O'Connell. I'm the president of Theta Chi here at UNT. Welcome to the house.
And then I'll show you the balcony. Morning.
Are you mic'd up right now?
Yeah, I am.
Oh my god.
Hey, where's mine? I'll see you later. All right, this is the balcony right now. You know, we usually have couches again, stuff like that, but it's tailgate day, so we don't got them right now. They're at the lawn. But yeah, so you can see a beautiful view of Maple Street, frat row as a whole. Over there, that's like the parking garage. Behind that's like our little food dining hall. Over there is all the sorority houses. And over there is like all of our like buildings and stuff for learning, because that's why we're here. But yeah, as you can see on the top, we got the Texas flag painted up, because you got to support Texas.
So I do have a roommate. His name is Garwin, also one of my day ones. He's our scholarship chair, so he makes sure we keeps in check of our grades and stuff. We're gonna do a room tour real quick.
You cast us, who cast us?
All right. All right, this is Garwin. This is my side of the room, you know, my little desk. This is my Halloween costume. I'm gonna be a fallen angel. I know it's kind of stupid, leave me alone. But yeah, it's my setup, doing some homework. I'm a big Heat fan. My bed, flags. Obviously I had to rep our chapter right there. Memorabilia, chapters. Over here is my closet, you know, pretty spacious. It's clean though, promise. And then like my favorite albums, kind of listed on the door frame. This is Mia, Garwin's girlfriend. And then this is Garwin's side of the room, you know, a very different kind of vibe. I'm going for more like crazy, like out there vibe. He's a very chill, like nonchalant. He's like low-key a nonchalant dreadhead, but he's like white as hell. All right, this is our bathroom. Again, we keep it clean here at Theta Car.
Hold up, wait a minute.
That's what we're about. Full functioning toilet. We got we got iced tea with an iced tea. And then we have this other Canes thing. It's kind of funny. A good shower, cool shower door. You have a pretty view of the back of chapter row or frat row. We got a urinal in here, which is crazy because I've never seen like a house urinal, you know. Obviously, Livy. Yeah, this is my side of the bathroom. You know, I got like my little caddy and stuff. I'm a big F1 guy, so I gotta rep it. And then this is our suite mates, Jackson and Sam's side of the bathroom.
I'm really like modern on the way I do my designs and setups. All right, so this is my room. It comes with a 6'3 black male.
Hey yo, what the?
It comes with plants, really good designs. Come with a monitor, a 40-inch TV. It comes with my roommate as well. That's painted over there. Look at my closet inventory. My clothes isn't that, you know. Actually, I think I have a good collection of clothing, in my opinion. Then my shoes. These are not all my shoes, but that is like I would say less than half. I do some artwork. Here's my sketchbook. Maybe we walk over here. Right. You wanna pin into that? You see it? Swag. Yeah, this is my room. There's my guitar. I have two big plants. I have one.
Do you play the guitar?
I play a little bit.
Okay, a little bit.
You wanna see?
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh my god.
It's really on tune.
Hell no.
I'll give it to you. Shut up.
Hey, hurry up. I'm trying to watch my Naruto.
Bro, shut the fuck up, bro. We put. Yeah. Hear that?
There you go.
Fucking perfect. Fucking perfect.
What's up, Noah? What's up, bro? Oh, it's not tuned at all, though.
That's why I use those two strings. Hell no. You need to tune that.
I do country. Shit. All right, no more.
I never stopped loving you.
You bitch. Yeah, but honestly, I feel like my room is like the most mature out of everyone's. If you compare my room to Tony's room is like, it's really bright. It's really gas. It's like, we're like NASCAR. I feel like each room has their own different font. Your room basically describes your personality and like what type of person you are. So I think I'm pretty like nature. I have like a lot of plants in my room, but Tony has a lot of car shit in his room, and he's like obsessed with NASCAR and F1. You feel me?
Ideally, how many people live in this house, first of all?
Ideally, we want to kind of pack it up as much as we can as like 30 people filling up this house. But right now we have 28 just because like two people have their own rooms, like they paid extra for it. So
the stereotype that frat houses are always dirty.
So far, this one been good. Remember, at the end of this video, I'm going to rate this experience with them and rate it and see where it ranks. But so far, this house has been good. From the backyard, from the ping pong table, everything. There's no trash anywhere.
We got the president of Theta Chi here at UNT. Look how tall he is. God damn. Making me look like a midget. But look, simple question. How long have you been the president here at Theta Chi?
So I've been the president for almost a year now. I plan on running again, so I'll hopefully make it 2.
Okay.
But I've been in the fraternity for about 2 years. Did recruitment for the first year and then decided I wanted to step up a little bit and kind of lead the pack, I guess is the best way to put it. So I've been doing that for a year and hoping to do it for another.
So far, how have people been loving your leadership? How is it going? So far, I'm liking it.
It's been a great time. It seems like everybody enjoys what I do, how I kind of decide to run things. I'm very, you know, open to criticism and hoping that people can also chip in and make sure that they have a say in what I do, because that's I don't want to be that guy that just kind of goes on my own little route and everything. But it's been good. I can't really complain, and I know the guys really can't complain either.
When was the first year that you rushed? Is this like your third, fourth year in a fraternity in general, or like how long have you been here?
So I'm going on my third year right now. I rushed in fall 2022.
Okay.
Originally, we had no guys, no house, no nothing. Just guys that were tabling out in the union that we were meeting and just seeing if we clicked with, and I clicked with them instantly and thought it'd be something that would be great to build up. And now we're here in this huge house with a bunch of people. So
I hear most frats, because some frats that I've been to have a DD, like a designated driver. Do you guys have any one of them here? Because I see some
Both
the
trailer. We've got plenty. We make sure that, you know, we make sure that we're making everybody be taken care of. Always got to take care of people, make sure they're getting home safe. Don't want anybody doing something stupid. So always got to do that.
This is the president, y'all. Make sure you guys go and follow their Instagram. It's linked in the bio right now. If you want to rush and become the University of North Texas, make sure you guys follow them. Russ, hey, reach out to him or one of the Rush shares so they can let you guys know how things go, man. Anything you want to say to the people?
Nah, man, just appreciate y'all watching. And we look forward to having y'all.
How do you feel about people saying that you guys are paying for free? Like sororities and fraternities are paying for free. What's your opinion on that?
Me personally, I just feel like we pay for the activities we do. I feel like Greek life is way much more than paying for your friends. A lot of our stuff is circled around our philanthropies and stuff like that. A lot of our girls have lots of special connections to what we do, and we put our hearts into all of the events we put together and all the money we raise for. Like us personally, we raise money for breast cancer education and awareness, so that's what we care about and what we do, and that's how we come so close together. So to some people it might seem like we're paying for our friends, but to us it means so much more than that.
Yeah, I also feel like I've met so many people through Zeta that I just wouldn't have met at UNT if I hadn't been in Zeta, because like my closest friends are all different majors than me and we just never would have crossed paths. So
hi everybody, my name is Amanda and I'm the social chair of Chi Omega.
Okay.
How do you feel about people saying that sorority girls love frat guys?
Like love frat guys?
Like that's their first option if they have to choose anything.
Honestly, I think that in Greek life it is pretty common for like a girl to like be with a frat guy. Like I'm dating a frat guy right now, but there's a lot of you know fish out there in the sea. So honestly, it's kind of your own type.
I would say no. I feel like a lot of girls have connections, with frat guys, but as well as like people. A lot of the time, like people you have in class. Like Greek life is very small here, so the percentage is very tiny. So the chances of you meeting someone in Greek life in class is kind of small. So people have connections that expand much more than just on Greek life, and it expands to a lot more on campus.
Yeah, I feel like we see them a lot, definitely at different events, because a lot of frats participate in our philanthropy and things like that. So we definitely get to meet them, but I don't say we have like a preference for them.
What's your name?
My name's Jojo.
Jojo, listen, this is the bar guy here at Theta Chi. Listen, Jojo, how's game day going?
Fun so far. Good. It was a long night, but it's starting to get active now.
Got to prep up.
Yeah.
So pretty much like how's the service at the bar?
The service at the bar, it's been good. Not a lot of people, so it's been a fun activity so far.
How you guys prepping for tailgates? I know you're gonna be over there, the bar guy. So how's the tailgate setup gonna be?
So last night they set up everything, thankfully.
Okay.
Other than that, we're really just trying to get people there safely.
Yep.
Yeah, rides and stuff like that. Uh-huh. So, but yeah, for now, everything's been set up last night.
I know. Listen,
there's a system.
There's another thing I've been hearing. You guys, there's a at most of these frats, there's a driver. There's a designated driver.
Yeah, DDs.
Who is the DD here today?
A lot of us.
Oh,
there's a good group of us, yeah.
Okay.
We're not allowed to, like, yeah.
But you're behind the bar and you're also DDs, so.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're making sure no alk in the system, everything is good to go.
Yep.
I like that. So, like, estimate how many, is it like 6-7 drivers or like there's more people?
About seven.
Seven?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just make sure people go there
and then get back.
Yeah. Safety.
For the after party, everything.
Yeah.
Make sure.
Have fun, but like we want to be safe.
Safety first.
Yeah, safety
drinking
first.
And driving, real talk. What's your score prediction today for today?
Oh, I have no idea. I think we're going against Tulane, right?
Tulane, yeah.
I'm hoping we pull out a win. Right now we're ranked fifth.
Okay.
We've been doing pretty good this football season. So, I don't know. Hopefully we come out on top by at least like a touchdown or two.
You ready for the game?
Hell yeah, bro. We're going to go to 6-2, hopefully.
Predictions.
What's that?
Predictions.
I think our offense is going to play really strong.
Okay.
Defense is probably going to struggle a decent bit. I think final score is going to be Mean Green 42, Tulane 35.
Maybe like 32 to like 20.
Who's winning today? Score predictions.
Oh, UNC for sure. We
of
got
course.
That on lockdown. We're
of
doing
course.
So good. We're like 5-1 right now.
Okay.
And I think... could be wrong. Someone double-checked that.
Okay.
But I think UNT is going to win today.
What's your score prediction?
Score prediction for today?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm saying 35-21 UNC. After
you guys have anything going on?
Got a little thing going on.
A little something.
Thing going on.
We can't tell you guys that. If you stay long enough, you'll see it in the video.
I'm a late bloomer, 3rd year on the scene. 20 racks don't feel like nothing to me. Cape in the streets, it turned me to a beast. Invisible set diamonds hugging my piece. But me for a show, I need 80 at least. I want the smoke and no key.
If you can't, come in here.
Open them up just like a surgery. Everything burning around me on lit. Show a little attitude.
He's a dog.
I spent 250, don't know where it went.
Yo, what you think? He's a dog. That is Zedekai. Rush Zedekai.
Big Red Bull, Rush Zedekai. Big Red Bull, Rush Zedekai.
What's you guys' like favorite fraternity on campus here?
Theta Chi.
Theta Chi, why? Because everybody's saying Theta Chi. Why Theta Chi?
Because they're comfortable and safe. Exactly. And their house is clean.
House is clean.
They're nice.
I hear it's a thing that people love frat guys. Is that true?
Yeah.
She said no.
She has a boyfriend. I love my boyfriend.
Why is that though? Like, why?
Honestly, frat guys are just really, really nice to me.
So you can't go for no other guys?
Yeah.
On camp, apart from only frat guys?
I happen to be in the events that I'm in.
Okay, so you're mostly at a frat event, so
yeah,
this is where you go.
Yeah, because I'm a sorority girl.
Okay. So. What's your sorority?
Zeta.
So third and long. Morris throwing for Sheffield. On the outside, he's got it! The Tulane Green Wave, 45, North Texas. 37.
Hey, Keith, fuck these niggas up. I paid some measure before we ain't come out and don't even wear the show. I ain't playing. I hit a bitch and I gave her some rats and I pull on my pants. She know I ain't stand. Go on a store run and get rubber bands. I done got rich, I done put on my mask. Choppers in traffic.
What do you dress up as?
I'm a construction worker.
She is a sexy
doctor
worker though.
She throw a hoodie on soon as we land. She don't like piss, I got too many fans. I'm running shit, I can do what I want, and it's really a limit. You do what you can.
Hey, yo, big C from Telecom, man.
Overall, the official review of the Theta Chi at the University of North Texas is gonna come down to an 8.9 out of 10. Great group of guys, amazing. They did your job. Hospitality was very great. Friendship-wise, everything was good. The party life is amazing. If you're looking forward to Rush at a frat at the University of North Texas, I definitely recommend you check out Theta Chi.
Like it's Marilyn Manson. Got the cash advancing. Give the Sprite and enhance it. Pull the walk out the pantry.
Listen, huge shout out to the guy here at Theta Chi at the University of North Texas for making this happen. Episode 1 of Texas Tailgate have happened. Now it's time for episode 2. I might be coming to a college near you, maybe UT, Texas State, UTSA, you never know. Stay tuned. Make sure you guys go and follow them. The link will be in the description. Just appreciate them so much for having us. Listen, make sure you guys subscribe, tell your grandma to subscribe, tell your grandpa to subscribe. And if you're new to the channel, hit the like button and also subscribe. And I'm gonna see your boys in the next one, man. Peace.
Straight to the top where I'm going. 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 Straight to the top where I'm going.
that's how I'm going.